One of the great local shows on this channel is called New Mexicast, and it's hosted, edited, directed, and produced by this lovely lady here, Rosalinda Roman.
Hi, guys. Nice to see you and meet you and see you.
Yeah. Good.
Yeah, New Mexicast. It's keeping me busy.
It is. Well, fill us in again. You're a busy mom. You have three kids.
Right. I have a nine-year-old and seven-year-old daughters and a three-year-old son. So that's really what keeps me busy. But
young Samuel is enough right there.
He is. They came on the show in the past.
He's a handful.
He doesn't care about TV. It doesn't mean anything to him. Right. And he was here. Remember, he wanted to eat the apples from the set.
Yeah. Kids are great. They just do whatever they want.
Pretty
they
much.
Don't care what's going on.
He didn't care. Fame and fortune, nothing to him.
And basically, the show is about your family, the experiences you have, and you capture it on video.
And my career was always broadcasting. You know, I was in mainstream media as a reporter and anchor for 12 years. And then once my daughter was born, I went and started my own show called New Mexicast. And so now most of my stories go where we go. Last week, you'll recall, we were in Arizona at the Grand Canyon and Kitt Peak. And this week, we're actually talking, back to basics, back to nature. I went on a field trip. Well, first, I'm going to tell you about beekeeping, because a friend of mine from high school who has been living here in Albuquerque, and I had not connected until recently through Facebook, she is a beekeeper. And
no kidding.
If you take a peek at some of the video,
okay.
I basically convinced her that I was going to just follow her around. And she did a master beekeeping class to teach others about the art of beekeeping. And, you know, I'm not afraid of bees, but, you know, when you have them zooming past you and going bzzoop, bzzoop,
your adrenaline
goes up a bit.
Oh, is that you there in the gloves?
No, I'm not in these shots, but I am in the story wearing that beautiful gear there. And I was the not very bright one that wore shorts that day.
Good.
Yeah, so my friend was kind of laughing, thinking that I was going to get stung, but I guess the bees were in a good mood that day, and I was okay.
Did they use the smoke and everything
to calm them down? Yeah, so she used the smoker, and we'll talk about that. That is,
my friend is teaching
this person how to. That's my friend in the corner. Her name's Laura. And she is she's showing them the techniques for handling the comb. And a lot of these people are amateur beekeepers in their own homes. And
now that they collect the honey and all that?
Yes. And it's just amazing to me that you can do this just, you know, in any city, anywhere.
Right.
I mean, people do it in Chicago.
Yeah, people do it in big cities.
Yeah.
I've heard of people and, I mean, how do you have it in your backyard? But they do.
They do. On rooftops, whatever.
Yeah.
So it's a fun story. I enjoyed going and learning a thing or two. I'm fascinated with bees, and my friend is really knowledgeable.
And so they take care of the bees.
Right. Yeah, they take care of us.
Yeah.
And then the second story, you know, the other thing is when you have kids, you end up going places with them a lot. And my daughter's field trip was to a place that I've heard of a lot, but never been. It's in Santa Fe, called Rancho de las Golondrinas. Have you guys been there?
I've been when I was probably about her age.
Really?
It's a long time ago.
Awesome. Yeah. It was just such a cool experience. I want you guys to take a look at some of the video. There's a blacksmith. He's, you know, basically what this place is they teach you how things were done in the olden days when they first moved, settlers came to this area and how they survived, and they give you hands-on activities that the kids get to participate in. So, like, this is my daughter making, what is it, masa? You know, the flour that they used, it's blue corn. And
people are in period costume and everything.
It was just so neat. And the kid, we honestly have to go back because we didn't have enough time with just the field trip time that we had.
What are they building there?
They are pulling the juice out of some kind of. I'll have to go back and look at it. But basically,
it's a mill.
It's not sugar cane, but something along those lines where if in the middle you'll see it kind of crunches the reed.
It
makes like the stuff that you make molasses out of. I mean, these are really cool things to experience.
It's great for kids to learn this stuff.
And for me.
Yeah, fascinating.
Yeah, so that's what we're talking about, and we've got some more fun stories coming up in the coming weeks. I went to Tucumcari for an iron pour, so we'll talk about that next week. And that was a really neat experience with people making some really unusual creations with iron. Very visual.
Well, I feel like I'm a member of the family.
You absolutely are, because every week you know, the fun thing about coming on here is it when I work so much in isolation because it's a solo show. Yeah. And so it's nice to come on and talk to real people, you know, not just kids.
Adults.
Right. Real adults. So thank you guys for supporting.
Thanks for sharing. Rosalinda's show, New Mexicast, you see it before this show every morning and then on Saturdays as well, right?
Yeah, that's right. They rerun it Saturdays and Thursdays.
So. There you go. So, and look at the website. Thanks for being on again.
Thank you, guys. Nice meeting you.
Thank you.
Rosalinda Roman, everybody, host and the producer of New Mexicast. Well, guess what? We've scared up old Howie Keibel, who's bringing the Halloween fun for us next from Yelp. That's next over on the couch here on the Morning Brew right after this.